Hello, my fellow anti-bottom fighters, and it is endgame time. We're reaching the point of the game where expert mode might actually start to cause me to lose a life. Here's stage 11, regaining the capital. Oh man, stage 11. Oh. This is the final appearance of many of these alliteration stage 2 stages, which are some of the harder ones in the game. We have all sorts of beauties here, like Marshes of the Delta. Even this level poses a threat for the Apex Bull. Marshes of the Delta, Bastion of the Cat Goddess, Wing of the Heart. Long story short, Amun Rising stage 11 is pretty dang trollish. Well, that was a waste. Well then, that happened. So, will I foul? I hope not. I really, really hope not, but it's a possibility, to say the very least. A very real possibility. Nice, okay, there we go. At least that scorpion was not a complete waste. So, for the sake of this, missed that. For the sake of this bit, wow, I'm getting like a ton of scorpions. That's decent luck, I guess. I was gonna say, for the sake of this video, how about you place your bets? When is the first time I will foul in this? When do you think is the first time I would score a foul? Because I myself honestly don't know, and I can't tell you the answer. It's something rigged. I've been scoring way too many scorpions. Oh well, whatever. There. Okay. At least it proves that it's not the levels. That the level's not rigged. I mean, like, wow, really? Scorpions by the dozen. Okay, so far so good. I mean, it could be worse. It could be a lot worse. But so far, nothing too, like, legit threatening so far. Scoring more power ups than normal, which means that my technique of scoring the all of the chains and combos is paying off. Okay, nice. We got ourselves another power up. Oh well. And wow. So much for saying stage 11 is tough, because I seem to be destroying all of the Apex Bull. Which is a pretty fast stage. This is one of the faster stages in the game. Like, it always was fast, but its final appearance is especially bad. Well, I guess I'll manage to prove it if the game doesn't stop giving me the scorpions, because it's being very unusually lenient with scorpions. Scorpions normally just don't drop often. Or is it like I've been scoring so many pops so often that a scorpion just has to show up? By the law of chances and averages and stuff like that. Yeah, probably. High possibility. Okay, that's bad. Anyway, part of the Apex Bull's gimmick is that when it's nearing the danger zone, it starts to block off incoming chains, and that's when stuff becomes a bit mean. Incoming line merge. I was doing pretty well until then. Okay, I guess I better focus now. Yeah, okay, I'm getting a bit of bad luck now. Oh sure, of course, you end now. Like, it isn't completely risky or anything. Sure, end here. Game. Don't throw me. But on the whole, if you made it this far in Luxor Amun Rising, you shouldn't have trouble with stage 11. You may lose a few lives here and there, but you won't game over. That's what I'm trying to say. Especially on beginner mode. On beginner mode, it's like, even the endgame levels are easy. Okay, there we go. And that's all of the Apex Bull. I did pretty decently well until like about 90% in, and I started losing my steam, and yeah, a train wreck is occurring. stage 11, there's two Marshes of the Delta. As I already mentioned, the last time I played this stage, I lost more lives here than any other level in the game. So let's pray for good luck, basically. Let's pray for good luck. Oh dear. Okay, good luck probably not gonna happen. Marshes of the Delta's gimmick is that it has a pretty short ending segment. Plus, the tunnel's really tricky to aim at. Like, sometimes I'm aiming at something different and the tunnel screws me over. Okay, there we go. So far, so good. Let's see, can I score a power? Yeah, that's power. Wow, ball! Absolutely worthless. That was close. It also has a pretty short ending segment, so it's the word to describe this level. Ah, Scorpion, very nice. That came at a pretty decent time. As you can see, expert mode is finally proving itself to be an expert, I guess. Heh, there we go. It's really hard to aim around it, Hunter. I don't know why, but sometimes when I'm aiming at one line segment, the spear hits to the other, even though I'm clearly aiming at a different one. Okay, thank goodness that was a change. Life. Very good, I could use that. Yeah! Oh, okay. This is pretty bad. Marshes of the Delta is one of the trickier levels in the game. Especially since it's a regular level, it's not like an extra level or anything. It's still tricky. Yeah, nice. Okay, there we go. Basically, just keep calm, score power-ups, you throw hits. Yeah, you see, I wasn't actually aiming for that, but it somehow bypassed the tunnel, so, you know, and since it didn't ruin anything, I guess I cannot complain. See, I was not aiming for that. Yeah, the tunnel is a bit awkward at that specific intersection. Screw you, tunnel. I really hate this tunnel. Plus, it messes with me getting my chains, which is very, very bad. There we go. I was waiting until it wasn't like a single color, so I could maximize my lightning bolt full effect. Thank goodness that hit. Power. Missed that royally. Plus, it doesn't help that I'm misaiming. Okay, nice. Hey, we actually 100%ed. Alright, so far so good. It could have definitely ended a lot worse, believe me. Alright, now I just need to clear one last line segment. How hard can it be? Says Konis. Near the end. I almost jinxed myself, too. I really almost jinxed myself there. How hard can it be, says Konis. Rule of thumb, never ever say that. That was Marshall Della, I did not foul there. Wow, I'm pretty impressed. As I mentioned, I died 4 times on this level the last time I played expert mode. So good. So far, so good. And to anyone who bet stage 11 dash 2 was the first time I was gonna foul, well, you just lost your money. Queen of Denial is next. This stage is after the previous one. It's like, what? Yeah, long story short, it's easy. You can still make it to the danger zone, but it's not getting in the pyramid. No way, dude. Not this level. Oh. Okay, that was some pretty bad luck with the colors. Okay, thank you, Scorpion. Wow, that is so much freaking combos at once. I was like nailing so much stuff. What? That is the first time I've ever seen that ever happen. That one is new. I have not seen that glitch before. Scorpion itself is glitchy, but I have never seen it stay in place. Well, now all of YouTube can see that glitch, because not a lot of people record this game. For the people who do record this game, they tend to record the HD version too, which I find some of the redesigned levels, I really do. I prefer the original art style. Oh wow. I somehow did not botch that up. Okay, congrats me. Hey, a lightning ball. However shall I abuse this? Let's like try to not aim it at the hilariously long vertical. I mean, I want to, but it's easier to use it to quick kill the next incoming chain like so, than to aim it at the vertical. Honestly, people, this is called optimizing your resources. And chain done, another one done, another incoming chain, another day at Luxor. Hey, look, this thing actually has a chance of ending. Nope, didn't even stand a chance. I was gonna say, hey, it might actually make it to the pyramid, huddy-duddy-duh. Yeah, right. No way. Ra's journey to the west is so much harder than Queen of Denial, it's not even funny. And the two levels are very similar, so I really don't know why it's like so much harder. I think it's the shape of the level. It is the shape of the level, most likely. But besides that, that's all I would say about Queen of Denial. Hey, it actually stands a chance of making it to the end. I'm actually a bit stunned. Another wild boss. Look at all of this nonsense. Look at it, really. So many spears moving at such ridiculously high speeds. It is expert mode. If it wasn't moving at a decently high speed that was at least somewhat challenging to someone like me, it doesn't deserve to be called expert mode. Oh, get okay. Ah, damn it! I was gonna save that for the next chain, but 100%. Well then, I sort of wasted that. So let's just get rid of you, I guess. Nothing much to say anymore. And that's Queen of Denial. Still easy. Still a joke. Oh well then. So far, so good. But the next stage is Bastion of the Cat Goddess. So my so far so good record is probably gonna go down the freaking drain. This stage sucks too. If Marshes of the Delta was bad, this stage is arguably even worse. I also lost a ton of lives the last time I played. So, Well, I totally botched that quick kill up. Oops. Bastion, one of the cat goddess, is hard because it's ridiculously hard to aim in this stage. And since it's ridiculously hard to aim, consequently it's ridiculously hard to score power-ups too. It's also pretty fast. Let's try not to underestimate this stage and hopefully we get some good luck. Good luck, Konis. Who am I kidding? The game hates me. Ugh. That was actually good luck. Okay, that's a line merge. Oh, that chain reaching the pyramid looks ridiculously long. Oops. Hey, double reverse! Nice! Even though it makes almost no difference since I got those reverse like one after another. Oh, it doesn't work. Well, I wasted that. I totally wasted that. Okay, I was a triple chain protocol. Again, as I mentioned, it's really hard to maintain it, so like you're most likely not gonna get a lot of power-ups in this game. I think I'm pretty well prepared for expert mode. Thankfully, again as I mentioned, I kind of played a lot of mods before this, and mods in general are harder than the original game. That doesn't mean the original games that I can breach to the original game. Like for example, I still can't guarantee I'll beat Khufu's Revenge first shot even to this day, because Khufu's Revenge is just one of those levels where you just hate it. You just hate it so freaking goddamn much. Quick kill does work. It just depends on how far to the right hold your mouse. Okay, that's actually really, really good. That makes Bastion of the Cat Goddess like so much easier. Okay, so I just need to play it calm, play it safe. Ah, the green! You troll! There we go. Nicey, nicey! So far, so good! I guess it's really been a while since I last played expert mode. The last time I played expert mode of this game was, of this game with Vanilla was, when I was recording my Luxor 1 playthrough, which was like, at least 1 year ago. Could be even more than that, and I didn't even play any mods. Then, so wow. Okay, I did a lot better than I expected. There's still a chance I might die. I mean, it's not likely, but there's still a chance. There is still a chance. Okay, the chance is like near 9-0. Now it's 0. First try, Bastion of the Cat Goddess, 11-4. So to those people who bet I was gonna die at 11-4, well, you bet wrong again!